911, what is your emergency?
Fire. All panels is on fire.
What is the address of the fire? I can't hear you. 911, what's the address of the fire? Sir, what is the address?
Yours.
Outside, if you're up at this early hour, lighting up the A skyline across Midtown and Buckhead. But what about the south of the city? Yeah, that's right. Today is the big day, the result of our poll. Wrong side of the tracks. We've been asking you to tweet poll. Email your thoughts on what our leaders can do to bridge that.
Mommy? Look funny.
Well, you have my nose and lips, so I would probably think of a better word to describe me.
You shouldn't wear that.
Why not?
That shirt with those shoes? Uh-uh, girlfriend.
Oh, yeah, and where did you go to fashion school, Missy?
Miss Summer's art class.
Well, I'm not taking fashion tips from a 10-year-old. Now go grab your bag.
It's the new towel.
Where did you find that?
In the garbage.
Well, it's not yours.
Daddy gave it to you.
Cassie, that was a long time ago, okay? We're not kids anymore.
So?
So, don't argue with me. Come on, I'm late.
Okay, but I still need $50.
For what?
Our Curry field trip.
What, that's today?
Daddy!
Wait. Cassie, shit.
There's my little lady.
Daddy!
Get over here, come on. How you been, huh?
Good.
You got a new outfit?
Yeah.
Pretty, look
Thank
at you.
Thank you.
You know, I think waiting a week to see you is too much. What do you think?
Yeah.
Morning, Pam.
Hey, Howard.
Morning, Pammy.
Oh, Dad, can you help me with my homework?
You know I can.
You were supposed to finish that yourself.
Oh, come on, Pam. Hey, you want to go see Uncle Howard?
Yeah.
Morning. I'll be right there. Hey, Pam.
What is it, Jeremy?
You know, I was just going to say you look beautiful today, that's all.
I'm in a rush. What do you want?
The cars in both their names. It's affecting the credit, that's all.
I'll take care of it.
I didn't mean it like that, okay? If you need help, I can.
We're not married.
We're not divorced either.
Not yet.
I think I've said sorry enough, don't you?
You left our daughter alone in the house.
I know.
And for what? So you could take a call?
Hey, Pam, it's been a year, okay? When are you gonna let it go? I look forward to seeing you and Cassie, you know that. How many times I gotta say I'm sorry for you to stop being crazy mad at me?
I don't know. How many whiskey sours does it take to forget?
Nice, Pam. You know, I've been sober 5 months. I'm trying, okay?
Okay, we have a couple issues to discuss, so let's just go ahead and get them out of the way. First, we need to keep our workplace clean. Second shift's been complaining about trash around the workstations.
Some of that shit is from third shift.
Well, be that as it may, Pamela nice you to join us. Secondly, and perhaps more importantly, State is making major cuts to our staff and benefits. So I'll be taking over for Richard for a bit while he's out with the flu. And I'll post the details next week when he gets back.
So who got axed?
I'm not privileged to release that information.
Don't worry, sweetie. You've only been here 2 years.
Three.
Yeah, well, they're firing employees with longer tenure and more benefits for those newer, cheaper workers.
Look, I don't make any decisions. That's Richard's call. He and upper management and both the state police and fire department are taking a 40% cut to the retirement benefits, so it's not just us who are affected. Look, let's just focus on the task at hand and get to our workstations. Pamela, could I see you for a moment, please? Have a seat. Seven years and a perfect record. Feel an itch? How much sleep did you get last night, Pamela?
Enough. Why?
You were late. Second time this week and fourth time this month.
5 minutes?
It was 10, actually. I requested to review your psych evaluation. Do you still dream about the fire?
No.
But you still claim that the caller burned your house down.
I listened to the tapes.
So did I. And you insist that the caller, when asked for his address, said yours.
No, he said 110 Hamilton Drive. It was just the way he said it. Like he knew it was my house. It's only when I dream I hear him say yours.
So you're still having a dream?
No, I'm fine.
Baby, be good.
Hey, brother.
For fuck's sake, man. Coffee and donuts.
Come on, try it. Green tea is good for you. Spinach, chicken wrap.
Nobody eats this crap.
2015, they do.
It's the last time you go for food.
So we're having a potluck on Tuesday, if you're interested. Should have done this a lot sooner, actually.
Done what?
No liquids by the workstations. Moved you to an easier district. Grace, Pamela is going to be starting today on the Eastern District.
Excuse me?
You must be covering suburbs and highways.
Tony.
It's lots of trees and grass.
Tony.
It's actually...
Tony. I've worked this station for nearly 20 years.
Grace, it's just a few days. I'll take the Northwest District this morning, then you can give Pam a lunch at noon.
I can handle the inner city calls,
no,
really.
No, have a seat, sweetie.
Really, you can let her have this workstation.
Don't mind her. I know you're probably looking for a raise or a promotion or both, but we're really under a lot of heat right now, so why don't we both wait until the smoke clears a little bit and then we can reevaluate? You're a good operator, Pam.
What's the occasion?
Occasion?
That outfit?
What's wrong with my outfit?
That wife, those shoes?
Who are you trying to impress?
My paycheck.
Yeah, with all the cuts they're making?
Well, you gotta at least try, right? Make some initiative. I read that somewhere.
What is your emergency?
There's a male here at East.
911, what's your emergency?
911, what's your emergency?
I haven't had a call in over an hour. Why is it always so slow around lunch?
Criminals eat, right?
Break time, baby girl.
Been on break all day.
Don't let Tony catch you with that.
It's all yours.
Oh, forgot my mirror. Just 2 minutes.
Hey, follow me, children. Over here, we have one of the city's most prominent monuments, established in the late 1890s, around the same time that the city itself was built. All right, over here, I'll show you guys something else. What is your emergency?
Such a lovely voice. Such a calming tone.
I bet you don't get told that
very much when people are calling in.
No doubt they're too scared out of their minds to notice.
Thank you.
My pleasure. So how does this work? I tell you the crime and the location, and you send assistance
to said location?
If I deem it necessary, yes, sir. What is your emergency?
No time to waste when lives are at stake.
You take your job very seriously, don't you?
Sir, this is a line for emergencies only. If you need a help hotline, I'll be more than happy to transfer you.
But I do have an emergency to report. Suppose I were to tell you that a serious accident on the corner of 5th and Dawkins is going to occur in 10 minutes. Then you could prevent it from happening. Would I have your attention then?
Oh my goodness. Are we still on the clock?
You think you have a shot with that?
What are you talking about? She looked right at me. You know what that means? I still got it.
I know what it means. It means you need glasses, dude. She looked right at me.
Had a butt like a 10-year-old, huh?
Really?
You know, you should enjoy her while you can at that age. Because right now, she thinks you're the coolest dude on earth. But by middle school, that's all over.
That early?
That early. My daughter started calling me pig in 6th grade.
I wonder why.
Who I am and why I'm doing this is none of your concern.
What I'm prepared to do is what you should be concerned about.
Sir, if this is some kind of a prank...
Well, then hang up on me. Ah, that's right. An emergency dispatch operator can disconnect once the caller has stated there's an emergency. No doubt by now you've tried discovering my location.
Did you find something interesting?
Listen, mister.
No. You listen. Report an accident on the corner of 5th and Dawkins over dispatch. You can believe me or not, but if you don't, then the blood of the victims will be on your hands.
Not mine. By the way, you're down to
4 minutes and 53 seconds. 52.
51.
That's a familiar voice.
Not really. Spoke to her today for the first time in a week.
I thought you guys were patching things up.
She said possible 41 auto accident. I mean, how does that make any sense?
It's 421 Fifth Avenue. It's close by. Let's take it. I look at it this way. At least now she'll have to listen to you.
670 radio. You said a possible 41?
10-4 2670. It was a confusing call on my end as well. Are you available to go check it out?
10-4. On route. Hey.
Take a look around.
Radio, this is 670.
Go for radio.
Yeah, we're here. There's no sign of a signal 41, nothing at all. Did you trace the caller?
10-4-2-670, I got nothing.
Copy.
Stand by, 2670. 911, what is your emergency?
You tell me.
Listen, I've had enough of your pranks. Are you aware that it is a felony to prank call an emergency to 911?
Oh no, a felony? Well, perhaps I should just stop now. So you sent a unit over to location like I asked. Did they find anything?
No, nothing. They found nothing because there is nothing there. You've wasted my time and the time of two police officers.
Are you sure about that?
Yes, I am sure about that.
Please, stop shouting. Remember that the primary responsibility of an emergency operator is to keep the caller calm. Check with your officer one more time. We must be certain before making any rash decisions.
Radio to 2670. Are you certain there is no sign of an accident?
No sign of a signal 41. Nothing at all.
Frank, call. Waste of time, huh? Get out of here.
Someone else to play games with. I assure you, if you had anything to do with that accident, you're going to be very sorry you ever dialed 911. Oh my God. Please don't hurt her. I will do anything you want. I can get you a hostage negotiator.
I don't want a negotiator, Pam. I want you. And I want you to cooperate. I chose you specifically for this task.
I can't do this.
Either you put the lives of a few pigs in a line of danger. Pigs that are sworn to protect and serve. Or you'll watch as your daughter struggles as she slowly submerged into the water. I always liked poetry. It's your choice.
Jeremy! Don't move. Look, just follow me. Just fall. Go ahead, I got you. I got you. There we go. All right. Come on. Come on now. All right. Come on, roll out. Roll over. Come on, man. Come on, Jerry. Let's go. All right. Just go out. Son of a bitch, you are lucky.
Now, let's set up the rules. Rule number one. You will ignore all incoming calls and remain on the line with me at all times. Rule number two. You will ask nothing of me, and you will answer any question that I ask you.
Rule number three, obey. You will comply with my every request, and you will see to it that it's carried out to a team. And you will do so without asking assistance from your co-workers, like you're attempting to do now.
You can see me?
It's surprising how easy it is to intercept the video of a high-security, state-protected building, even from a safe distance. Take a sip of your coffee.
That's not mine.
I'd hate for something to happen to your daughter because you're disgusted by the thought of drinking after your friend.
You ready?
Yeah.
Whoa, 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 whoa.
Nothing. You see anything?
I was pulling you out of the car. It's some kind of hit and run, man.
Thanks, buddy. You came straight at me.
You better call backup.
Radio 670 requesting code 21.
What do I say?
An officer is calling for backup, Pam. So send up some backup.
10-4-670.
The accident didn't happen until we got here. What the hell's going on?
Careful.
I don't know. Radio tiny available units. I'm requesting code 21 to 421 Fifth Avenue South.
10-4, radio. This is 206040. En route.
See, that wasn't so hard, was it?
Sorry about that. It's not easy looking beautiful all the time. You ready for that break now?
Ignore her.
It's okay. I'm in the middle of a call, so...
Oh, I'll take it over.
No, she won't.
No, really, I'm gonna finish this one.
Just give me the call, Pam.
Deal with her.
I know you're trying to get a raise, sweetheart, but you don't have to impress the callers, too.
I'm warning you.
It's not that. I just want to finish this call.
Enough, Pam. Get up.
Get rid of her now.
Hell, I can use 15.
I just hate office drama.
The officer you were speaking to, he's quick.
He's just a cop doing his job.
I think he understands what we're trying to accomplish.
We? I don't even know what we're trying to accomplish.
I'd like to report another crime. Property damage at 1731 Withervane Drive. Send 2670 to check it out.
He was just in an accident. Besides, a cop can't leave the scene of the crime when he's the first to respond. Are you still there?
Figure something out. I'm not going to do your job for you. If he isn't at the scene in 5 minutes...
Okay. Okay. Just don't hurt her. I'll see what I can do.
Okay, guys. Guys!
So you're saying you stayed here to check out an accident, and then an accident?
Yeah, man, like I just told you. Homeboy here plowed straight into me.
Wait a second. That doesn't add up at all.
No shit.
Listen, radio for 2670.
Go for 670.
I've got a lead on that suspect. Somebody spotted him at 1731 Withervane Drive. Requesting a code 12. Are you able to pursue?
Confirm that. That cruiser was damaged in the crash. We're going to be cruising in cruiser 644 from this point.
Hold on. Wait. Are you out of your mind? You can't leave the scene of an accident.
Unless we're pursuing a suspect. Four? Attempted homicide with a vehicle?
You don't know what the hell he looks like.
That's what we're going to find out. You coming?
Well done, Pam. That police officer, Do you know him?
Why would I know him?
You called him by his name. Jeremy, I think it was.
I heard it over the radio.
Are you attracted to him, Pam?
I know the names of a lot of police officers. I talk to them all of the time. It doesn't mean that I know them or that I'm attracted to them.
And if he has another mishap and can no longer walk away from the scene, or if he's killed in the line of duty, tell me, Pam, would you shed a tear for Officer Jeremy?
No.
What day of the week is it?
Friday.
So where the hell is everybody?
Long weekend, maybe.
Nah, I don't think so. Something's up. I'm gonna have a look around. Make sure no one leaves, huh?
Copy that.
Anyone here? Police officer! Six-seventy for radio.
Go 670.
We got code 23. Nobody here. It's empty. Hey, Howard, you got anything?
No, I got nothing.
Gotta be kidding me.
They're on the way.
Wow. You even know the name of his partner. You do care about this one.
They'll find you. Do you know what they do to cop killers in prison?
For me to go to prison, I would have to get caught first. And I have no intention of getting caught.
You underestimate him. He will find you.
He? Who's he? Pam. Is a hero going to barge in?
And his police blues and put handcuffs on the bad guy. Is that how this is going to play out?
How many times have you received an emergency call from a bad neighborhood, only to discover that the police
wouldn't go there simply because they're not guaranteed their safety? Or have you ever been walking home and heard the screams of someone calling for help? What do?
Do you rush to their assistance? Or do you put your head down and just keep walking?
We're all bad guys, Pam. We're all complicit in crimes. We turn a blind eye to death every day. No one weeps
for the victims. We only care when it happens to someone important to us.
You're insane.
Am I? Or am I the only one with a clear head? The only difference between you and I is that I have the conviction to go after what I want. And on that note, I have another crime to report.
No. No, I'm done helping you. Are you there? Did you hear me?
Watch your screen.
No. No, please. Stop.
Pamela, remember, a 911 call operator must remain calm at all times.
Please, stop. I'll do whatever you want.
I understand your hesitations, Pam. But don't for a second think that I'm not prepared to do what is necessary. Don't defy me again.
What do you want me to do?
Send Officer Jeremy and his partner to 12 Westmont Circle, breaking and entering.
Only cop I used to take his kids to school every day. He used to play with cash all the time.
They all end up the same way sooner or later.
Playing us, you know that? Waiting for us to get to the scene.
Why do you say that?
Read this.
Guys, why didn't you tell me about your daughter? Don't you think we should call this in?
He's got dispatch. He has everything, every damn thing we say. No.
2670.
Go 670.
I've got a report of a signal 42 at 12 West Mount Circle. Are you available to check it out?
Look, it's just you and me, Howie. This asshole can't know we're onto it. Okay?
Right.
10-4. Now wait.
Oh.
What?
Incoming.
Aren't you gonna answer that?
You better do something. She's making a scene.
How many calls did you put on hold?
Grace.
What are you waiting for? Answer the damn thing!
No, stop! Hello? Are you really there?
Just hung up on them. You bitch.
What the hell's going on here?
She's ignoring callers.
That's not true.
Grace, I don't even want to hear it.
Tony.
What are you, 9 years old? Enough drama.
She's ignoring callers.
And if she were, I would know about it. Already won, thank you very much. Back to work, please. Take a 15.
Hello? 911, what's your emergency?
You broke rule number one.
My co-worker pressed the button.
Don't let it happen again.
Hey, yo, this is 670. ETA communication for approximately 3 minutes.
10-4, 670.
Are you sure there isn't something going on between the two of you? His last name wouldn't happen to be Miller now, would it?
If you already know it is, then why are you asking me?
No questions. You've been lying to me.
I didn't lie. We're separated.
Is he handsome?
He has brown hair, blue eyes. He's a good... He's a thoughtful man.
And yet you're not with him. Or is he a crooked cop?
No, he's a good person.
Then why, Pam? Why aren't you with him? All right, that's enough for now. Compose yourself. You don't need anyone asking questions.
almost there. Something on your mind?
Yeah, sure. Got my wife and daughter. Can't do anything about it. I'll trace some numbers a little bit.
Guy's just covering his tracks.
Thing is, when I was working as state detective before we wrote together, we had this case on traceable numbers, dozens of them. You can't break it. Even got the FBI involved.
So some idiot is pulling prank phone calls and you couldn't find them. Big deal.
Come on, Howard, think about it. If you're going to this much trouble, there's going to be a bigger picture, right?
Like hacking in the security cameras of a state-operated building, right?
Exactly.
What happened with you and Pam?
That night in the fire, you know, when Cassie Lee got killed? It hit me hard, you know? I went off the deep end, I got suspended, and I got demoted.
So that's how you ended up back in uniform?
Sure.
Pam left you because she blames you for the fire?
She blames me because I wasn't there that night.
She had a point.
What the hell is this? I take the back, you come. Is anyone in here? Anyone? Anyone here? 600 radio, we have a signal 33, 12 West 1 Avenue, code 3. Anyone here? Police officer! Police officer, anyone need help? Hey, wait! We have a possible 1070 heading eastbound.
Cops all day. Why?
I'm the first one I've seen all day.
Okay. What were you doing in there?
Somebody pay me. I don't know his name.
Yeah, I was supposed to be there an hour before and set fire to the place and make it look like an accident, okay?
But I took too long and you caught up with me. Look, I swear,
Just shut up. What do you look like?
I don't know. Normal? White guy? Look, he met me on the street. Today's the first day I met him, okay? Now just...
What are you doing?
I thought he had your gun.
You're a police officer. How are you going to explain this? 670 radio.
Go for radio.
I have a suspect down to code 33 requesting fire and EMT to location.
Jesus Christ, Howard, you can't just shoot a suspect. Poor kid was just a pawn, had no idea what he was into. $10,000 is a lot of money for this kind of job. Somebody might have done pretty bad, huh? Georgia National.
What?
Couldn't be.
Howard. Howard. You have a second? Hey, take a look at this.
That doesn't make any sense.
What are you talking about? It makes perfect sense. That untraceable call case I told you about, six of the same bank branches were hit by those numbers. When they torched my house, all the security files to the bank were in my home. Coincidence? You know what I think? Same people planned to tow shit all along.
Jeremy, take a breath. Take a breath. This is a little too close to home for you. I know they got your daughter, but listen, everything we've done today, we can answer for. But this, dispatch isn't sending us, and we don't have probable cause.
What's going on with my daughter here? She's seen their faces. You think they're going to let her go?
Yeah, but you don't even know she's going to be there. You've convinced yourself she's there because you want to be the one who saved her.
Oh, come on,
you don't
bullshit.
Know that. If you're wrong, she's dead.
Send your officers to 3814 Willow Street.
What's the crime?
A shooting, suspected gang activity.
Can't I send someone else? They've got their hands full.
Do as you're told.
Oh, yeah, they'll kill her. As soon as they don't need her for leverage.
As long as we do what he
radio
says.
Radio's 2670.
Follow his direction. She's going to be
okay.
Fine. That's your
go for radio.
I've got a report of a code 25 at 3814 Willow Street. Possibly gang related. Are you available to check it out?
Let's take it. Let's play along.
10-4, I'm route. Hey, Howard, I'll drive.
Anarchy. Chaos. Haven't you ever wondered what would happen if the safety parameters that society puts in place for us were simply removed? What if you called 911? And no one answered?
Then a lot of innocent people would die.
Of course you'd say that.
But you're not talking about safety.
You're talking about shackles. Don't you see you can't force a person to do anything?
You have to get them to buy into a system. But every system has an organizer, a person who wields control.
And what about those people you killed today?
I didn't say no one would die. Simply that I would return man to his true nature.
At the end of the day, you're no more special than the hundreds of criminals this office deals with. I think you're just too weak to fit into your so-called system.
Well, then, it seems you've figured me out. I'm impressed.
What are you doing? Willow's to the south.
Not going to Willow, going to the bank.
You out of your mind? What's going to happen when we don't show up at the other location?
Well, he thinks we're going to Willow, right? Time we get there, get to the bank, we'll be too late.
You don't know how many people could be there. We could be walking into an ambush.
Get out. You want to do this? You want to back me up? She's not your daughter.
It's my wife. If I'm going to die today, I want to tell her I love her one more time.
They should have been there by now.
Maybe they hit some traffic.
I don't think they're going where I told them to.
You heard them on the call.
You lied. And it's created a serious fucking problem for me.
I can fix it. Let me fix it.
Such an adorable girl. Perhaps she'll be even more adorable if she's a lifeless corpse.
Do anything you want me to do. What do you want me to do?
Convince him, Pam. Convince him to go to Willow Street, or you'll watch her goddamn head underwater. Do it now.
2670, confirm you are en route to Willow Street.
58
for us in 3 minutes. Hurry.
anything?
Messy shit. You want to go around the other side?
I'll radio you when I'm in place.
Got it.
Where the hell are they?
My daughter.
Who are you talking about?
Who hired you?
I ain't telling you shit. Don't come any closer. I'll blow this bitch's brains out.
Let her go. Put the weapon down.
You have no idea what's going on here, do you?
I will take the shot. Let her go. It's the only way you're gonna walk out of here.
Please help me.
Put it down. You didn't sign up for this. Put it down. Put it down. Put it down. Good. Drop it.
What are you talking about?
You like doing things your own way. Well, it's time you learn the consequences.
Okay, come on.
Oh.
Okay. Okay. All right. All right. Come on. Well, here you go, man. There. You've done this before, right? All right. The EMTs will be here any second.
Dispatch. Tell Officer Jeremy to get the money the women were taking from the bank and meet me at 643
Hawthorne. I repeat, 643 Hawthorne Street. Tell him to come alone. It will be a civil exchange. He gives me the cash money, I give him Cassie.
Let me see my daughter.
I make the rules.
No, if you want me to cooperate, then let me see her.
Next time you fail to cooperate, she goes all the way under. You understand?
How am I supposed to deliver a message if I can't use the radio?
Why don't you use that cell phone you've been texting him with all day?
He can't just walk out of there with all of that money.
He has a gun, doesn't he?
Pam.
Jeremy.
You okay? You said you couldn't call.
Are you at the bank?
Yeah. Hey, look, Cassie's not here.
Didn't you get my text?
No, I had to turn it off when I came in here.
You had to be the one to save the day.
I'm not trying to be a hero, okay? I'm trying to save our daughter.
Now he's nearly killed her. He wants you to bring the money to 643 Hawthorne Street. Alone. He says he's going to give you Cassie in exchange for the money. But Jeremy, he's not screwing around anymore.
I know. You get it. Hey, I love you, okay?
Just go get Cassie back.
You're not gonna like it.
I haven't liked anything you've done all fucking day.
You gonna back me up on this?
Yeah.
Okay. Everybody, on the floor, now. You.
The manager. Come with
me. I must applaud your effort. I thought you were going to use desperation, but guilt is a much stronger motive here.
What do you care? I'm just a pawn in your game.
You know the funny thing about pawns and kings, Pam. The king is usually miserable. Too many things to do, too many consequences to weigh. Too many people depending upon him, and too many people plotting against him. Count your blessings, Pam. Not everyone has what you have.
He says we're not going there without backup. The dispatch is compromised. Stanton, it's Howard. Listen, I need a big favor. You got to call up every man you can. Have him meet us half a block south of 643 Hawthorne Street. Stay out of view of the building. No, don't use the radio to organize this.
He's gonna do it?
Yeah.
Thanks, man.
What do you think we got back there? 2 or 3 million?
Probably more like 4.
Buy a beautiful house with that. Tempting. That's it.
They get my daughter help.
A miscommunication. It's not going to happen again.
I'm going to have to let you go.
What about our deal?
I'll still be listening and watching. So see to it that there are no surprises and that this transaction with your husband is completed as promised.
What's going on?
It's ransom.
There's money in there?
They've got his kid. Let's just keep our eye on the prize, okay?
I go in, give him the money, get my daughter back.
Shouldn't we set up a perimeter?
This guy's been one step ahead of us all day. He sees you, she dies.
Look, I don't like this.
Now, this is my daughter.
We haven't scouted the location. We don't have a perimeter. And you got us working this off the book. Why isn't the captain involved in it?
Hey, why we have a compromised dispatch. One police officer's been killed. We don't know who we can trust anymore. I'm asking you to let me go in there, get my daughter into a safe zone. You can take it from there. Handle it how you want. Just asking you to wait here. You good?
What's your emergency?
Hello, are you really there?
Yes, ma'am. This is 911 dispatch. What is your emergency?
Bank robbery. There's a bank robbery happening.
Ma'am, calm down. The police are aware of the robbery. It's being dealt with.
No, you don't understand. It's happening right now. Two guys with guns are holding us hostage.
Ma'am, that's impossible.
Listen, you bitch. I've been trying to get through for the last 40 minutes. They're taking everything. I'm at Georgia National Bank, 228 Crenshaw Boulevard.
Excuse me, where did you say you were?
Georgia National, 228 Crenshaw Boulevard.
That's impossible.
Sorry? Are you listening to me?
911, what is your emergency?
2 minutes, I've taken over Georgia National Bank.
What's your location?
1462 Farragut Drive.
911, what is your emergency?
We've got a bank robbery.
Which bank?
Georgia National, 4658 Crosby Street.
This is 670 to SWAT. No one's here. I repeat, no one's here.
What do you have?
Footprints up top. They cleared out, man.
Same. You sure?
Yeah, 10-4.
You know it's protocol.
Thanks again. Pam.
Jeff, it's not.
I can't hear you, baby. Cassie's gone, okay? He's playing this again.
I know. Cassie.
No, look, baby, I can't hear you. Hang on. Pam, you hear me?
Don't go in.
Pam!
Don't go in.
Well, what are you talking about? No one's here.
It's a trap.
Cassie's not here.
It's a trap. He's not hitting one of the banks. He's hitting all of them. They're all getting taken right now.
And that you are the chess master.
I told him to come alone.
They called in for a SWAT team to back them up. I counted 20 of them.
20?
21 casualties, if you include our officer, Jeremy.
You're gonna burn in hell for this.
Careful, Pam. You still have a job to do.
What the hell makes you think I'm gonna do anything you ask me to do?
Because I'll blow your kid's fucking head off if you don't. It's your job to remain calm, not mine. Now, I suggest you compose yourself unless you want to lose a second family member.
Pam, are you okay? Yeah, I'm fine.
That's right. Because I still need you, Pam. My accomplice. I couldn't have done this without you. You're the one who sent Officer Jeremy and his partner to those scenes before the crimes happened. And you're the one who told him to take the money from the bank. And you're the one who sent those officers to their death. And now the only one who can corroborate your story is dead.
I never would have helped you. You threatened my daughter.
Fear is what drives mankind to his greatest accomplishments. Only someone with the nerve to overcome his fear can scale the highest mountain when a lesser man wouldn't dare. Or rob 10 banks simultaneously. No doubt you've figured it out by now. It's a shame you didn't figure it out in time to save Jeremy. Tell me, are you still afraid?
What should I do?
One more crime to report. Call in a hostage situation at 1296 Faulkner Boulevard. The emergency dispatch center.
Who's taking the hostages?
You are. Convince them, Pam.
Radio to all available units. This is dispatch operator Pamela Miller. I have taken the dispatch center at Faulkner Boulevard under my control, and I have a number of hostages.
criminal behind the events that took the lives of two civilians and a number of police officers. As many of you know, my husband, Officer Jeremy Miller, used to be a state police detective before being demoted. He was so dedicated to his job that he put the safety of our daughter in jeopardy. And afterward, he was simply cast aside. We're all disposable. It is only through fear that we are able to get the attention of those with power.
My plans to rob Georgia National Bank earlier were stopped. So I want my money brought to me here, or I will begin executing hostages. That is all. Where is she? Where is my daughter?
Calm down, Pam.
Hey,
back off.
It's okay.
Everybody just relax.
Oh, you really done it now, Pam.
How did you block that call?
Blocking its source is easy if you're in control of the system. But I needed a cell phone to coordinate with my people in the field. I just didn't anticipate that you'd find that number. Well done, Pam.
Where is she? Where is my daughter, you son of a bitch?
Why don't you just relax and sit down?
Get back! This is the man responsible for the bombings. He has my daughter.
I would do no such thing. You gotta be careful, Pam.
Why would you do this to my family? Why me?
I needed Jeremy, too.
What?
A state police detective investigating a bank chain, architecture plans, money import trends. All I needed to do was find a way to get into his computer. So, I fed him a dead-end lead that night.
What night?
Pamela, just put the gun down before someone gets hurt.
Night of the fire.
My daughter was in that house.
Why don't you listen to Grace, Pam? You two were so mad at each other that you didn't even care what was left in the fire, including Jeremy's laptop.
So what's your plan? You're just gonna disappear? All the calls in here are recorded. Eventually, they will pin it back to you.
Like that gun you're holding? Guess who it's registered to? Jeremy. It's the one he thought he lost in the fire. So you tell me how you're going to explain that.
Ma'am? Ma'am, put the gun down now!
I'm not the criminal!
She's crazy. She was sending cops all over the
street. Shut up! He has my daughter! He took over my line. You can look at the call logs.
Look at who has the gun.
Ma'am, put the gun down now.
I can't. If I do, he's gonna kill her.
Kill who?
My daughter! He's been robbing the banks all day. Please.
Ma'am, you gotta stop this.
I thought you were dead.
I made it out.
What about Jeremy?
He didn't make it. We can solve this. We can make it right, but you gotta put the gun down, baby. Please. Think about Cassie, Pam.
How'd we do?
The other nine went down without incident. A little over 200 men.
Good work, baby.
Pulled it off.
Still gotta get out of town.
What about my payment?
I didn't forget about your payment. Thank you. Let's see what you got.
Baby, it's me.
Jeremy?
Yeah. Baby.
I thought you were dead.
Did it hurt you?
No. No. I'm sorry. I never should have said all those things.
Oh, come on, baby. I understand. I deserved it. Do you have any idea where she is, baby?
Not without my computer.
Does this work? Got it? Hey, we gotta go.
What was that number?
Here. It's gonna take long, baby.
Depends if he used the phone in the last 10 minutes. He's on it right now. Highway 11, eastbound. Okay.
Call you when we're a little closer. With any luck, we're about an hour away. Be ready for us. Anything?
Nothing.
Yeah, don't worry, little girl. You'll be seeing your mother very soon.
Getting close?
A mile or two at least.
Shit.
What are you doing?
Calling the precinct. They can head us off.
Mr. Carter.
Captain, it's Miller.
Miller? Jesus. Where you been?
Just want you to know, those guys that took the Georgia National today, we're in pursuit right now.
They just took your ex in custody. They told me that she was in on it.
No, she wasn't. They were using her.
Son, I know that this has been an emotional day for you. We can't argue with the evidence.
Captain, listen to me. She's with me right now.
Hi, Captain.
Oh, I'm sorry, Miller.
You don't chase the criminals fair enough. We're heading eastbound on the 11. Track us.
Miller, stop what you're doing.
Yes. Hey. You're gonna need this.
What? I can't.
Baby, it's just you and me. I can't do this without you. Okay?
No, I've never fired a gun.
I know that. Listen, soft trigger, two hands. They will try and kill us, baby, so you have a shot. You do not hesitate. You take the shot. You hear me? You hear me? We're gonna get her. You'll be fine. I promise you. Is that them?
It's gotta be.
So which one is it?
I don't know. The lead one?
Are you sure?
No.
I told you, see a shot, you take it. Stay low, baby. Come on now, get down. Get around back. Stay low. Stay low, stay low.
not just about money, Pam. It's about history. No one's ever had the smarts to take down 10 banks at once.
$200 million. What are you shooting at? Don't do this. Jerry, don't do it, man.
Where's my daughter?
She's in there. And this time, I'm gonna let her burn.
Jerry, don't do this. Don't be stupid, man. It's $200 million fucking dollars. It's what Pam wants. It's all she wants.
What is your emergency?